Hebrew Israelite Bible Study. The Book of 2 Baruch, Chapters 49:2-52, 1-7. The Nature of the Resurrection Body. And the Final Destinies of the Righteous and the Wicked. In what shape will those live who live in your day? Or how will the splendor of those who are after that time continue? Will they then resume this form of the present, and put on these entrammeling members, which are now involved in evils, and in which evils are consummated, or will you perchance change these things which have been in the world as also the world? And he answered and said unto me, Hear, Baruch, this word, and write in the remembrance of your heart all that you shall learn. For the earth shall then assuredly restore the dead, which it now receives, in order to preserve them. It shall make no change in their form, but as it has received, so shall it restore them, and as I delivered them unto it, so also shall it raise them. For then it will be necessary to show the living that the dead have come to life again, and that those who had departed have returned again. And it shall come to pass, when they have severally recognized those whom they now know, then judgment shall grow strong, and those things which before were spoken of shall come. And it shall come to pass, when that appointed day has gone by, that then shall the aspect of those who are condemned be afterwards changed, and the glory of those who are justified. For the aspect of those who now act wickedly shall become worse than it is, as they shall suffer torment. Also as for the glory of those who have now been justified in my law, who have had understanding in their life, and who have planted in their heart the root of wisdom, then their splendor shall be glorified in changes, and the form of their face shall be turned into the light of their beauty, that they may be able to acquire and receive the world which does not die, which is then promised to them. For over this above all shall those who come then lament, that they rejected my law, and stopped their ears that they might not hear wisdom or receive understanding. When therefore they see those, over whom they are now exalted, but who shall then be exalted and glorified more than they shall respectively be transformed, the latter into the splendor of angels, and the former shall yet more waste away in wonder at the visions and in the beholding of the forms. For they shall first behold and afterwards depart to be tormented. But those who have been saved by their works, and to whom the law has been now a hope, and understanding an expectation, and wisdom a confidence, shall wonders appear in their time. For they shall behold the world which is now invisible to them, and they shall behold the time which is now hidden from them, and time shall no longer age them. For in the heights of that world shall they dwell, and they shall be made like unto the angels, and be made equal to the stars, and they shall be changed into every form they desire, from beauty into loveliness, and from light into the splendor of glory. For there shall be spread before them the extents of paradise, and there shall be shown to them the beauty of the majesty of the living creatures which are beneath the throne, and all the armies of the angels, who are now held fast by my word, lest they should appear, and are held fast by a command, that they may stand in their places till their advent comes. Moreover, there shall then be excellency in the righteous surpassing that in the angels. For the first shall receive the last, those whom they were expecting, and the last those of whom they used to hear that they had passed away. for they have been delivered from this world of tribulation, and laid down the burden of anguish. For what then have men lost their life? And for what have those who were on the earth exchanged their soul? For then they chose not for themselves this time, which, beyond the reach of anguish, could not pass away, but they chose for themselves that time, whose issues are full of lamentations and evils, and they denied the world which ages not those who come to it, and they rejected the time of glory, so that they shall not come to the honor of which I told you before. And I answered and said, How can we forget those for whom woe is then reserved? And why therefore do we again mourn for those who die? Or why do we weep for those who depart to Sheol? Let lamentations be reserved for the beginning of that coming torment, and let tears be laid up for the advent of the destruction of that. But even in the face of these things will I speak. And as for the righteous, what will they do now? Rejoice you in the suffering which you now suffer, for why do you look for the decline of your enemies? Make ready your soul for that which is reserved for you, and prepare your souls for the reward which is laid up for you. Shalom.